writers of the presentation is experimental and numerical modeling of physical coils that are loading. First, I will introduce you to about the title and the artwork. This is my group member, Kalyathan, Shriyathani, and Archidiki. The title of the project and the video, we did a lot of experiment on the project in physical coils to find their capacity of lateral loading under like earthquake loading, wind loading, and flood loading. The introduction of the helical coil. This is the structure, steel structure manufacture used in a deep foundation under a very large building. Heavy load. The basic components of a helical coil include the jet extension, helical bearing blade, and coil. Here is detailed in the figure. You can see in the figure there is a extension upper part of the coil and the lower part is the lead which is drilling in the ground and other which coupling shock bracket. This is the helical coil picture and the history of the helical coil. It's used in the late of 18th century and early in the 19th century. The various of lighthouses were constructed on the helical coil along the helix with the number of helixes like 2 helixes, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. The helix increased the capacity of the helical coil with increasing the number of helix. This is the pattern history of the helical coil, including the era, marine era, agriculture era. The use of the helical coil in the basics of the early of the 19th century. So for the to proceed with the final presentation, I would like to invite to Shujatani. Thank you.
Now I discuss the benefits of helical coils. Basically, several benefits of helical coils. Firstly, that they resist core and metal refining for heavy applications. Also, they can be used for circular applications. Can fold from one place to another place. They are easily transported to remote sites. Also, from that we can check the verification capacity of medical files. They can be installed to groundwater in casing. They are also required a best time to install. Can be installed in a better angle having for better capacity. They can be also installed with smaller and more accessible equipment. Medical pipes can also be covered in place after installation and they can be galvanized for drilling intervention and drilling resistance. Also, when they are completely in power, they do not produce dense spoil from earth. Advancing the speed of piling to the site to the utilization of our line. And now moving towards the problem statement of the project, to find the lateral capacity of helical pipe versus conventional pipe. Now methodology, experimental analysis to determine the lateral capacity of helical pipe. Now practice used in their project, LVDTs, linear and vertical displacement transducer, load set, sandbox, little auger, helical pile and pile rod. Here is picture of LVDTs, little auger, helical pile, pile rod, lateral load set and sandbox. Then moving toward procedure, first of all we have to fill the sandbox by mobile permeator with shutter height of 18 inches. Second, positioning of piles and pile rafts in sandbox. Then LVDs are attached to the top of rod at bottom corner parallel to the application of rod to find the lateral deflection. Then load cells are attached to the lateral load pump to measure lateral displacement. Lateral load, they are attached to the left arm through data logger. Then hydraulic pump is turned on which applies lateral load, and the data from the data logger is captured in the left arm. The load is increased at the very low, at very slow rate, which can assume a static load. Then for numerical analysis, I would like to invite Sanyal.
Thank you for giving me the chance. After experimental analysis, we go through the software, which is Plexus 3D software. We did the numerical analysis in that software. And the procedure for numerical analysis in the Plexus 3D, so first we have the type of soil and soil conditions of Plexus 3D. After that we match the model and then finally we got the results. And in order to do the numerical modeling in plasticity, we will set a number of parameters in the plasticity to get a certainty result. The following parameters are set in plasticity. So we set the soil properties as hardening soil, drain and unit weight distance and internal fracture distance 3.71 and the stiffness are these. These are the strength parameters, and the pile model is the length of the pile is 18 inches and distance between the two heads is 3.7 inches and dia of helical plate is 1.5 inches and external dia of pile is 0.5 inches. And these are the shaft dimensions and these are the helical plate dimensions. And this is the model in the Plexus 3D and this is the mesh model. These are the results we got from the pile. These are the six piles results. Experimental results for the six piles in the helix model. And these are for the nine piles experimental and this is the final result we got from the experimental analysis, which is from conventional pile and single endeavor helix pile. This is for the six piles. And this is for the nine piles. Load is in Newton and the displacement is in Kelvin. So after that result, we can include